Good morning to our listeners, both on radio and our social media platforms. My name is Krishna Joseph, and we are here live at the State House Conference Center for the President Charities Foundation, Inc. Cheque Donations Presentation Ceremony, which is happening today at the State House Conference Center, where 13 charities will be receiving checks from the President Charities Foundation. We are currently awaiting the arrival of Her Excellency Sylvani Burton and Mr. Burton to mark the official start of the ceremony. However, the guests of honor are in attendance, along with former Presidents Charles Savare and Mrs. Savare and Eliud Williams. They are already sitting and in attendance for this ceremony. This will be Her Excellency Sylvani Burton's first President Charities Cheque Donation Ceremony. Of course, Mrs. Burton took up office after being sworn on October 2nd, 2023, becoming Dominica's first female president. And not only that, she's also the first person of Kalinago heritage or descent to hold the office of president in the Commonwealth of Dominica. A few guests are also arriving as we speak, and before the official start, I can tell you that the 13 charities being awarded checks by the President's Charities Foundation, Inc. are the Dominica Association of Persons with Disabilities, St. Jerome's Ministry, Dominica Council on Aging, REACH, Our Lady of Fairhaven Conference of St. Vincent de Paul Society, the National Society of St. Vincent de Paul Limited, the Social Center, Operation Youthquake, Maho Senior Citizens Home, Community Hostel Inc., formerly known as the Grotto Home for the Homeless, Abilities Unlimited, formerly known as the Workshop for the Blind, the Dominican Infirmary, and the Alpha Center. So representatives from these 13 charitable organizations are already seated, along with members of the President Charities Foundation, Inc. While we await the official start, the guests are being serenaded by a Christmas playlist of Christmas songs from long ago. Right now, O Come Let Us Adore Him is being played. We can tell you that seated are members of the Dominica Charities Foundation, Monel Alexis, and also Mrs. Ramonda Hyacinth, who is the treasurer of the President Charities Foundation. We have government ministers making their entrance. The Honorable Miriam Blanchard and the Minister for Health, Kasani Laville, has just entered. And we will also be seeing Dr. Cassandra Williams, the Minister for State in the Ministry of Health, Wellness and Social Services, with special responsibility for senior security, children at risk, gender affairs, and the differently abled, who will also address us during these proceedings here today.
Thank you. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. We are in the Advent season, at least in my church. And
thank you very much. I would like to declare divine atmosphere here. And now we sing, O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel that mourns in lonely exile here until the Son of God appear. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Let us pray. Almighty and loving God, we thank you for this day which you have made, a day when our President, Her Excellency President Silvani, will continue the tradition initiated by the late President Nicholas J.O. Liverpool of presenting cheque donations to 13 charitable organizations through the President's Charities Foundation, Incorporated. We pray that these donations will be put into good use by the recipients of such a presidential largesse, so that during this forthcoming season of liberality and happiness, those who will be served may experience hope, peace, joy, and love. Jesus, Savior of the world, bless, protect, and guide our President, her husband, family members, her staff, and our entire country. In Christ's name we pray.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours forever and ever. Amen. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Please be seated. And thank you very much, Monsignor Eustace Thomas, for that invocation. Now, the best way to feel, or rather to not feel hopeless, is to get up and to do something. But don't wait for good things to just happen to you. If you go out and make some good things happen, you will fill the world with hope. You will fill yourself with hope as well. And this is a quote from Barack Obama. Now, today is all about the President's Charities Foundation giving hope to 13 charities organizations in Dominica. The donations are given with hope and the anticipation of great things that will follow. At this juncture, I recognize Her Excellency Silvani Burton, President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, and Mr. Burton, His Excellency Charles A. Savre, former President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, and Mrs. Savre, His Excellency Eliud T. Williams, former President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, Honorable Dr. Vince Henderson, Minister for Foreign Affairs, International Business, Trade and Energy, and Parliamentary Representative for the Granby constituency. Honorable Miriam Blanchard, Minister for Labor, Public Service Reform, Social Partnership, Entrepreneurship and Small Business Development, and Parliamentary Representative for the Roseau North constituency. Honorable Kasani Laville, Minister for Health, Wellness and Social Services, and Parliamentary Representative for the Maho constituency. Honorable Dr. Cassandra Williams, Minister of State in the Ministry of Health and Social Services with specific responsibility for senior security, children at risk, gender affairs, and differentially abled. Monsignor Eustace Thomas, officials of the Embassy of the People's Republic of China, sponsors, representatives of the various charitable organizations, present and past members of the President's Charities Foundation, the media, the listening and viewing public, good morning. And on behalf of the President Charities Foundation, we apologize for the delayed start. My name is Marnell Alexis, and it is my pleasure to be your guide this morning. And I want to thank you very much for being here. So to officially invite us, or rather to welcome us to this event, I invite Mr. Oliver St. John, the Public Relations Officer of the President Charities Foundation.
Good morning. Let me recognize Her Excellency, Mrs. Sylvanie Burton, President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, her husband, Mr. Burton, former President, His Excellency Charles Savre and Mrs. Savre, His Excellency Elliot Williams, also former President. This morning, we are here once again to witness another of the President's Charities Foundation presenting checks to the various charitable organizations on the island. This initiative started, as the chairperson, Master of Ceremonies, said to you, during the reign of Dr. Liverpool, and it continues to this day. And I'm very sure and confident that with our new president, it will continue. I want to welcome you here, especially the recipients who will be receiving on behalf of the various charity organizations. I want to welcome in our midst the various ministers of cabinet, parliament, and to everybody who's listening and viewing via the worldwide web media, call it which you will. Today is the day that we of the President's Charities Foundation are happy to be here and to present what we feel and we know is something substantial and important. Our less fortunate brothers and sisters, especially the elderly, are gems we are supposed to protect. And one of the many ways in which we can do that is by assisting them and the organizations who are taking care of them. And the Charities Foundation is very, very proud that we are able to play a role in that regard. And we will continue to do so. Our members are dedicated and committed, and we will do everything possible insofar as seeking to ensure that our less fortunate brothers and sisters, and again I emphasize, the elderly, are given the kind of care and attention that they deserve. But we know that this doesn't come easy. It has its financial challenges, and hence the reason why, again, our sponsors must be recognized for the contribution they are making. The wider community, because the monies that we are going to be giving out today come from our major fundraising activity, which is the President's Charities Dinner, which is held annually. And whilst the sponsors do make a significant contribution, but we cannot overlook what is spent by the people who purchase the tickets to attend the dinners. So, having said that, I always take the opportunity at the microphone to encourage more persons to participate and get involved, because we would like to do more than what we are currently doing. But to do so, we need the resources. So again, I'm taking this opportunity to implore and to ask everybody to make that little contribution during the period of the dinner to purchase a ticket so that you can help in the process of making lives better for our less fortunate brothers and sisters. Let me take this opportunity now to wish each and every one of you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Welcome.
Thank you very much, Mr. St. John. And thank you also to the sponsors for your donations, and we're hoping that you continue on with our foundation in 2024. You can leave your names at the end of this event. Thank you in advance. We continue. Up next, to present a brief remarks, I would like to invite to the podium Honorable Miriam Blanchard, Minister for Labor, Public Service Reform, Social Partnership, Entrepreneurship and Small Business Development. She's also the parliamentary representative for the Roseau North constituency. Minister Blanchard.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Before I begin, let me recognize in our presence Her Excellency Sylvanie Burton, the President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, and Mr. Burton, His Excellency Charles A. Savrin, former President of the Commonwealth of Dominica and Mrs. Savrin, His Excellency Eliud Williams, former President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, my cabinet colleagues here today, Honorable Kasani Lavelle and Honorable Dr. Cassandra Williams, Monsignor Eustace Thomas, officials of the Embassy of the People's Republic of China, sponsors, representatives of the various charitable organizations, present and past members of the President's Charity Foundation, the media, and the listening and viewing public. Good morning to each and every one of you. Before I begin, allow me to apologize on behalf of one of my colleagues, Honorable Melissa Poponskerit, the parliamentary representative for the Roseau Central constituency, who hopes to be here with us this morning to welcome you to the city of Roseau, as is customary for her, and to be able to join in this momentous occasion. Regrettably, she's unable to join us, but she sends us warm regards for a great event. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a great pleasure to stand here before you today on this occasion of generosity and kindness. Our collective efforts to support each other are indeed the cornerstone of progress and resilience here in our beautiful island, Dominica. I extend my heartfelt appreciation to the Office of the President for orchestrating this noble endeavor, the annual Cheque donation presentation ceremony. The President's fundraising dinner and various philanthropic activities have culminated in a momentous occasion here, where 13 charitable organizations are receiving significant support. Among these are organizations, institutions that are close to our hearts, such as the Dominica Council on Aging, the Social Center, REACH, the National Council of St. Vincent de Paul Society, and the Dominica Infirmary. Their unwavering commitment to uplift the vulnerable and to serve the communities echoes the very essence of unity and compassion. This support signifies not just financial assistance, but the resolute belief in the causes that these institutions and organizations champion. Madam President, your generosity and dedication to these initiatives reaffirm our commitment to building a more inclusive and compassionate society. Through these contributions, we are ensuring that vital services, care, and support reach those that are in need the most, serving as a beacon of hope, lighting the way for a brighter future for all. As we gather here today in the spirit of giving and solidarity, I am reminded of the warmth and generosity that define this season of joy. Christmas is a time when our deeds are guided by the spirit of love and kindness. The gifts we give today, beyond their material value, carry the profound message of hope and support for our fellow citizens. They embody the very spirit of Christmas, the spirit of giving without expecting anything in return. Let us carry the spirit throughout the season and beyond. Let us spread joy, love, and compassion in everything we do, in every word we speak and in all of the lives that we touch, a boundless compassion that I am convinced resides in each and every one of us here today and in Dominica. I extend heartfelt congratulations to the recipient organizations and my deepest appreciation to all contributors, sponsors, and volunteers whose tireless effort has made it possible for us to be here today. May our collective commitment to goodwill continue to shine brightly, enriching the lives of all those we serve. It would be remiss of me to end without taking this opportunity to wish everyone a Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year, especially my dear constituents of the Roseau North constituency. Happy holidays, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Minister Blanchard. And as she reminded us, we give and expect nothing in return. We continue with brief remarks from Honorable Dr. Cassandra Williams. She's the Minister of State in the Ministry of Health, Wellness and Social Services with special responsibility for senior security, children at risk, gender affairs, and the differentially abled.
Her Excellency Sylvanie Burton, President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, and Mr. Burton, His Excellency Charles A. Savra, former President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, and Mrs. Savra, His Excellency Elude T. Williams, former President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, Honorable Miriam Blanchard, Minister of Labor, Public Service Reform, Social Partnership, Entrepreneurship, and Small Business Development, and Parliamentary Representative for the Roseau North constituency, Honorable Kasani Laville, Minister of Health, Wellness, and Social Services, and Parliamentary Representative for the Maho constituency, Monsignor Eustace Thomas, officials of the Embassy of the Republic of China, People's Republic of China, excuse me, sponsors, representatives of the various charitable organizations, present and past members of the President's Charities Foundation, the media, and the listening and viewing public, a pleasant good morning to all of you. It is an honor to be at what can only be described as a ceremony that reflects the heart of who we are as a people, a caring people. For more than 15 years, the President's Charities Foundation has been a beacon of kindness, love, and care for those most in need in our beloved country. As a Minister of State in the Ministry of Health, Wellness, and Social Services, with distinct responsibility for seniors' security, children at risk, gender affairs, and the differently abled, I have become attuned to the needs of the most vulnerable among us. Sometimes it takes sitting in a seat where the view is clearer to really grasp the extent of what the people need. We are in a time when we need to actively look out for each other and take care of the most vulnerable in our society. We need to ensure that every vulnerable population has the care and support needed to survive, not only in times of crisis, but from day to day. We are in a time when there needs to be heightened community responsibility, a time when it is not enough to depend on the acts of government to ensure we take care of each other in every possible way. And the charity of the President's Foundation is reflective of the social responsibility that we all should embrace. Safeguarding the most vulnerable is everyone's responsibility. Ever so often, we see upsetting reports in the media where there has been a serious failure to protect our vulnerable citizens from harm, abuse, or neglect. Thankfully, those incidences are reducing, and organizations such as the DAPD, Dominica Council on Aging, the Dominica Infirmary, Community Hostels Inc., and so many others look at the lessons learned to minimize the risk of recurrences. But what we don't see reported in the media are the many times where these very agencies across Dominica have done their jobs well, and they've stepped in to keep children and adults safe from harm, abuse, and neglect. I believe this should be highlighted some more, don't you? And with donations such as these institutions are better able to do the jobs they are tasked with, to advocate on behalf of those who are unable to advocate for themselves, to care for those who do not have that capacity. And my ministry will be working right alongside you, providing the necessary support and development, or developing and implementing the relevant legislation to make your task a bit easier. Let me, on behalf of all these organizations that fall within my purview, thank the President's Charities Foundation for this significant gesture and for continuing to recognize that while our social services teams have a crucial role in keeping the children and adults in our communities safe, we all have a responsibility to protect our most vulnerable citizens. And while I wish to profusely thank the President's Charities Foundation, I would like to use this opportunity to publicly thank all those who work tirelessly to care for those who are infringed upon. You too are a reflection of who we are at our very core, a caring people. May God bless our nation, and a very Merry Christmas to all of you.
This ceremony is a reflection of who we are as a people, and caring for the vulnerable is everyone's business. Thank you very much, Honorable Cassandra Williams, for these encouraging words. Up next is someone who is passionate about caring and supporting the vulnerable persons in Dominica. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to welcome to the microphone Her Excellency Sylvanie Burton, Dominica Award of Honor and the President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, to present some remarks.
A pleasant good morning and a Merry Christmas to each and every one of you. It is with great pleasure that I acknowledge the presence of our Master of Ceremonies, Miss Monel Alexis, my husband Gilbert, His Excellency Charles A. Savarin, immediate past President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, and Mrs. Savarin, His Excellency Eliud T. Williams, former President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, Honorable Miriam Blanchard, Minister for Labor, Public Service Reform, Social Partnership, Entrepreneurship and Small Business Development, and the Parliamentary Representative for the Rosenhof Constituency, Honorable Kasani Laville, Minister for Health, Wellness, and Social Services, and Parliamentary Representative for the Maho Constituency, Honorable Dr. Cassandra Williams, Minister of State in the Ministry of Health and Social Services, with specific responsibility for senior security, children at risk, gender affairs, and the differently abled, Monsignor Eustace Thomas, officials of the Embassy of the People's Republic of China, our dear sponsors, representatives of the various charitable organizations, present and past members of the President's Charities Foundation, the media, the listening and viewing public. There is a special joy in my heart today. The cause of this great joy is twofold. Firstly, we are in the season of Christmas that is supposed to be a season of great joy and meaningful celebration of the anniversary of the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And secondly, in this time of caring and giving, we are being provided with another opportunity to gather here to witness and participate in the foundation's usual Cheque donation presentation ceremony. Being able to once again contribute to the well-being of our vulnerable and disadvantaged brothers and sisters is enough reason to be glad and thankful. Our God is truly a good God. My husband and I are indeed happy to be here and to be in your good company. At today's ceremony, the President's Charities Foundation will be presenting Cheque donations totaling the sum of $36,000 to 13 of its 16 beneficiaries. Three beneficiaries, namely the House of Hope, the Northern Home for the Aged Grange, and the Care for the Poor, were presented with their Cheque donations during my Christmas visits, which took place earlier this month. The overall sum of $44,000 will be distributed this year, similar to last year's figure. These donations are from a combination of past sponsorships from traditional sponsors and proceeds from the fundraising dinner, which took place on Saturday, 14th October 2023 at the Jungle Bay Resort and Spa. An interim statement on the fundraising dinner revealed the following figures as at 19th December 2023. Total receipts from ticket sales, sponsorship, and contributions, $87,389. Total expenses, $36,479.72, resulting in a surplus of $50,910.28. In addition to donations to 16 charitable organizations, we were also able to fund the foundation's children's Christmas party. This party took place on Saturday, 9th December 2023, from 1 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. on the main lawn of the State House. A total of 273 primary school children, ages ranging from 5 to 12 years, from the communities of Canefield, Massac, Maho, Campbell, Warner, Taru, Layu, St. Joseph, Salisbury, Monrachet, Coolibistri, Collyhoe, Biosh, and Dublin were entertained. The children had a fun-filled day and left the State House with a smile on their faces. The balance from this year's fundraising effort will go into the foundation's reserve fund for disaster relief purposes. The charitable organizations to receive checks this morning are the Dominica Association of Persons with Disabilities, St. Jerome's Ministry, the Dominica Council on Aging, REACH, Our Lady of Fairhaven Conference of St. Vincent de Paul Society towards the Roseau Branch, the National Society of St. Vincent de Paul Society, St. Vincent de Paul Limited towards the Northern Branch, the Social Center towards the St. Anne's Day Nursery, Operation Youthquake, Maho Senior Citizens Home, Community Hostel Inc., formerly known as the Grotto Home, Abilities Limited, formerly known as Workshop for the Blind, Dominica Infirmary, and the Alpha Center. A formal vote of thanks will be given later, but I wish at this juncture to make special mention and to register profound thanks and appreciation to the following sponsors for making it possible for the foundation to again meet its charitable mandate, despite the setbacks posed by the many global challenges. These sponsors include the Embassy of the People's Republic of China, HHV Wechurch and Company Limited, the Aid Bank, the National Bank of Dominica, the National Cooperative Credit Union, the West Coast Cooperative Credit Union, the Dominica Social Security, Dominica Electricity Services Limited, DOMLEC, DeWitt Center, Springfield Trading Limited and Belfast Estates Limited, Rudolph F. Thomas Enterprises, M&R Trading Limited, Rock Hard Cement, Construction Materials and Services Limited, TA Dragon Windows, Specialty Making and Materials Limited, Zoo Windows, Stowe & Company, Legal and Offshore Services Providers, Intercontinental Dominica Cabaret Resort and Spa, Jungle Bay Dominica Resort and Spa, Archipelago Trading Limited, Secret Bay Resort, L'Express de Zille, Val Ferry Services, Flow Dominica, Digicel Dominica, and Print Express. May the good Lord continue to bless your efforts. Special mention and thanks also goes out to all those who sold tickets and patronized the fundraising dinner. We look forward to the continued support of our patrons, sponsors, contributors, and well-wishers. I further wish to take this opportunity to recognize the stewardship and contribution of all my predecessors. I am happy and appreciative that His Excellency former President Charles Savre and Mrs. Savre and His Excellency former President Eliud Williams were able to forego their Wednesday commitments to be here with us today. Thank you, and we do look forward to your continued support. The Office of the President and the President's Charities Foundation look forward to embarking on some new initiatives in the new year with community-based organizations that are geared at enhancing the lives and livelihoods of our vulnerable and disadvantaged youths. Should you have any ideas that will help us realize positive outcomes from this special project, please do not hesitate to contact the Office of the President. I thank you for attending and for the courtesy of your attention. May the love, hope, joy, and peace of Christmas be yours, and may the good Lord favor you and your family with a better and brighter new year. May God bless us all and this beautiful land we call home. I thank you.
Thank you very much, President Burton. So the children left this ground with their faces filled with bright smiles. So guess who's going to be leaving here smiling today? Anybody? Okay, so that is the members of the charitable organizations. So now it's time for the main event. At this time, we now have the presentation of check donations to the 13 charitable organizations to be followed by brief remarks by the recipients. First up, Dominica Association of Persons with Disabilities. To present, I invite a representative from the Dominica Social Security, Mrs. Melicia Etienne Atenol, Administrator, Contributors Department. Receiving is Ms. Ernica Esprit, Executive Director.
Good morning, everybody. And season greetings to everyone. On behalf of the Dominica Association of Persons with Disabilities, it gives me great pleasure to express heartfelt and sincere thanks to the President's Charities Foundation. And the generosity and kindness of the foundation is exceptional, and it should be highly commended, because all of us, all the recipients here today, will leave with a twinkle in their eyes and a big smile on our faces. And I thank the charities, the President Charities Foundation, for putting that twinkle and smile on our faces. We take this opportunity on behalf of the members and board of directors of the Dominica Association of Persons with Disabilities to wish the President Charities Foundation all the best in their endeavors, especially next year. And I know that a call was made for more people to come on board, and more people will come on board so they can do more. Everybody who's hearing my voice and I can contribute, if it's the ticket for the dinner or contributing whatever way you can, please do so. Once again, thank you.
Thank you very much, Miss Esprit. I forgot to mention the twinkle in the eyes. Yeah? So we're leaving with smiles and twinkles. And thank you again, Miss Anatol. Yes? We continue with St. Jerome's Ministry. The presenter, representative from Springfield Trading Limited, Miss Tirella Alexander, marketing manager. Representative receiving is Miss Melanie Henderson, the coordinator of St. Jerome's Ministry.
For those of you just tuning in, we are here at the President's Charities Foundation, Inc., a Cheque donation presentation ceremony at the State House Conference Center, where 13 charitable organizations will be receiving their cheques from the organization.
Good morning to all here present. I am not able to mention every officer here, but everybody here, a hearty welcome this morning. It gives me great joy today to know that as a recipient for St. Jerome's Ministry, that is in Granby, that we have been always thought of, and the very thought of selecting us is as great as receiving this today. I want to extend thanks to all those who have been engaged, Mr. Eliud, Mr. Savarin, Mr. Liverpool. Though he's dead, we need to remember these are the pioneers. We cannot say thanks to him, but his work should make us remember him. And hoping that we, the recipients, also have a job to play, a part to play in that. We need to help our beneficiaries to understand the efforts that has been put into making this day what it is for them. And also on behalf of them, I want to express sincere thanks and hope that this will serve the purpose for which it was intended. Mr. Henderson, our power rep, I want to say a hearty welcome and a Merry Christmas. And we know we are living in perilous times today. The world is in danger, and we are part of the world. And therefore, we need to pray a little harder, pray more devotedly, and pray unselfishly. To everyone here, I wish a Merry Christmas and a peaceful New Year. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Henderson. And I saw Monsignor Eustace smile when you mentioned praying a little harder, you know? And as we should. We continue. Presentation to the Dominica Council on Aging. And the presentation made by representative from Do It Center in the person of Samira Sebastian. She's a financial planning and analysis manager. Receiving on behalf of the Dominica Council on Aging. Okay. It's Mr. Ensworth Irish.
The Dominica Council on Aging has just received their Cheque donation, which was presented by a representative from the Do It Center. A total of $36,000 will be presented to 13 of the 16 beneficiaries of the President Charities Foundation.
Charles Savre and Mrs. Savre, Mr. Eliud William, former president, government ministers. I recognize also the representative from the People's Republic of China, Monsignor Eustace Thomas. I see Mr. Victor Kovac from Digicel, the CEO is here. Representatives from the various organizations. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests. Mr. Nigel Lawrence, who is the president of the Dominica Council of Aging. He was on his way here this morning. And he had a mechanical breakdown of his vehicle. And as the second vice president, representing another organization here, with the advent of the technology, he sent me a message and asked me to receive on behalf of the Dominica Council on Aging. So I have to say a big thank you to the President Charity Foundation for this noble occasion. The Dominica Council of Aging, as you know, we look at our senior citizens. And at this moment, we have 14 centenarians. And we continue to work tirelessly towards the plight of the less fortunate in Dominica. So I want to say I'm very elated here this morning to receive on behalf of the Dominica Council on Aging. I can assure you this will go a long way in helping us to develop our programs. So I want to just also add that I wish Your Excellencies and everyone a blessed Christmas and a bright and prosperous New Year. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Irish. And though some may have mechanical breakdowns, we will leave here with smiles on our faces and twinkles in our eyes. We continue. Up next is Reach. The presenter, representative from Secret Bay Dominica, Mrs. Marvelyn Alexander James. She's a director and special projects and strategic initiatives. Representing Reach, Ms. Sonia Newman, executive director.
Her Excellency, President Sylvani Burton, and her husband, and everyone at the head table. Good morning, all. From the board and staff of REACH, in case you do not know what REACH really means, is reaching elderly, abandoned citizens, housebound. We are very elated to be a recipient from the President's Charity Foundation. It will certainly assist in bringing Christmas cheer to our elderly. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you very much, Ms. Newton. We can add to our little list that we bring Christmas cheer, right? So we live with a smile on our faces, twinkle in our eyes, and with a lot of Christmas cheer. Got this. We continue. Up next is a representative from the National Council of St. James de Paul, St. Vincent de Paul. Society? Is anybody present? So Representative Mr. Marcel Harrington, the Treasurer, and the presenter, Ms. Bertilia Bethel James, Mrs. Bertilia Bethel James, Marketing and Communications Officer for Aid Bank.
Yes. Great thing happen when God mixes with man. I want to recognize the president. I've never been in a place where you have three excellencies at the same time. I'm saying. President, so I want to recognize President Savre and President Elliot Williams, all the ministers of government. Your Excellency, I think from China, I want to recognize you and everybody invited here today. It's in fact a distinct privilege and pleasure on behalf of the St. Vincent de Paul to receive this gift of love, especially at this time of the year when we're celebrating love, the joy of Jesus Christ. And I can assure you that this loving, caring donation will be used exactly as you said. I think you said this was for the Northern Branch. I can assure you that some needy, some vulnerable father, child, mother, daughter will in fact smile better and be happier this Christmas just because of the work of love that is manifested clearly here today. And I want to say a big thank you to you, President, and to your team. And wish you the best going forward. I mean, it's just, I am so happy about this particular situation because the thing is that we're going to make somebody happy this Christmas. And it's always nice to see a needy person, a vulnerable person smile because of your efforts and the efforts of your team. So once again, thank you and Merry Christmas to all.
Thank you, Mr. Harrigan. So we learned one more thing today. We're living with a smile on our faces, twinkling our eyes, filled with Christmas, and we're saying, yes! We continue. We move on to the St. Anne's Day Nursery. Representative Ms. Deborah Charles, coordinator of the Early Childhood Development Program. And the presenter is Mr. Kenny John Charles, sales representative of Specialty Making and Materials.
Pleasant good morning to everyone here. On behalf of the coordinator of Social Center and staff, especially the St. Anne's Day Nursery, I would like to express my gratitude to the President Charities Foundation for this contribution to the St. Anne's Day Nursery. Your Excellency, as we all know, Christmas is a time for sharing. And in this year is no exception. Though it is your first time in the office as President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, you ensured that this event continues. To you, I say thanks, and also to the members of the President's Charities Foundation, the corporate organizations, all those who patronized the dinner, I say thank you. In one way or the other, if you have done something for the success of this event, heartfelt gratitude. Once again, I thank you all ever so much. At this point, I would like to wish everyone a blessed Christmas and a bright and prosperous new you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Charles. So I'm learning a lot of things today. So we have one word, and it's called gratitude. You heard that word today? She's mentioned it a few times. So we have to remember to show gratitude. Very good. So we're going to go from the top. We're going to leave here with smiles on our faces, twinkle in our
eyes,
filled with Christmas,
cheer,
saying
yes,
and showing gratitude. Very good. We continue with Operation Youthquake. Representative Mr. Lennox Abraham, the director, and presenting this check is a representative from Construction Materials and Services Limited, Mr. Robert Han. He's the chief executive officer.
Your Excellency Sylviana Burton, your husband, Mr. Burton, the past president of Dominica, on behalf of the residents, staff of Operation Youthquake, and the board members, I would like to say thank you. After 45 years in existence, we have been receiving a check from the foundation for 15 years. So for this, we are grateful. Let me take the opportunity to wish all of you here this morning a Merry Christmas and a happy 2024. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Abraham. So, you know, I'm learning words today. He mentioned the word grateful because they have received checks for how many years? 15 years. So that's excellent. So it's important to be grateful. So we're going to go from the top. Good. So we're living here with smiles on our
face,
twinkles in our
eyes,
filled with Christmas,
cheer,
showing
gratitude,
saying
yes,
and being grateful. Excellent. We continue with the Mao Senior Citizens Home. Representative Ms. Natalie Sampson, and she's the president of the board. And the presenter, representative from West Coast Cooperative Credit Union, Mrs. Marlene Daniel Etienne. She's a systems administrator.
Excellency. Mrs. Sylvani Burton and her husband and members of the head table or the invited guests, good morning.
Good morning.
The operations of the Mao Senior Citizens Home began in February of 1981. Initially, the home provided only shelter for some residents of Mao who were displaced as a result of the damages suffered by Hurricane David in 1979. Meals and laundry services, etc., were provided by the family members. As the residents grew older, the status quo changed, and so it was necessary to provide all the services needed by the elders. Having realized the need, we started full operations as an institution of care for the elderly. Like many similar institutions, we have had our challenges, but we have been able to navigate through the rough waters, and we are still navigating, but with the kind and generous support of the President's Charities Foundation and many others we have been going through. Let me therefore, on behalf of the residents of the Mao home, the management committee, and the staff, extend our deepest thanks and appreciation to Her Excellency Mrs. Burton and her husband, Mr. Burton, together with the other members of the foundation for their continued support and for always remembering the Mao home at this time of year. We are very thankful that we have been able, or you have been able to share with us the success of your fundraising activity. In closing, let me extend to you and members of the foundation best wishes for a very joyful Christmas and a new year blessed with health and happiness. We look forward to you visiting our home sometime in the future, as many past presidents have done. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ms. Sampson. And Madam President, she looks forward to you visiting our home soon. All right, so we learned something from her, and it's navigating rough waters, because sometimes it's rough, right? So now we're living here capable of navigating rough waters. We're going to add this. So we're living here with smiles in our, twinkles in our, filled with Christmas, saying, yes, showing, being, and being capable of. That's what's up. Yes. We continue. Up next, we have the Community Hostels, Inc., that is the Grotto Home, represented by, I have Mr. Ainsworth Irish, the president, and presented by a representative from Domlec, Ms. Tamra Paul. She's the acting public relations officer.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I have two bites of the cherry. Again, Your Excellency and Mr. Burton and all other excellencies, distinguished guests, I want to say on behalf of the board and directors of the Grotto Home for the Homeless Community Hostel, Inc., how grateful we are. We are very thankful. As you know, the Grotto Home have been going through some challenges, but I'm happy to report that the government of Dominica, of course, have stepped in, or as they have always done, and just recently took over the salaries of the Grotto Home. In fact, the staff just recently got 3 months of retroactive, June, July, August, and the government will continue to pay the salaries. And today, I know you have given us a substantial contribution because I got the letter inviting me here today. So I want to say how happy we are. Of course, the Grotto Home caters for 40 residents, destitute citizens. And besides, we've been having some challenges, but I'm sure now that, you know, as the government has really stepped in and doubled up the efforts in terms of helping the plight of the citizens and the elderly who have really worked tirelessly, this will go a long way. So again, I want to say thanks to Your Excellency. Just 7 days ago, last Wednesday, I received from Your Excellency, I got a call, and received in excess of $1,000 worth of grocery items. And this went a long way in toiletries and all sort of things, a long way in helping the Grotto. So once again, I wish you God's blessing and a bright and prosperous new year. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Ainsworth Irish. Now, remember, I'm learning a lot of things today. So, but he did mention biting and cherries, right? So he said bites of cherries. So today you all are receiving a lot of donations. So we call this bites of cherries. So you're enjoying what? Bites of? Awesome. Let's go over it from the top. You're living here with smiles on your, twinkles in your, filled with Christmas, showing, being capable of navigating, enjoying bites of, and saying, yes. We continue. With the workshop for the blind, representative Miss Raina Raymond. She's the acting craft teacher. And the presenter is the representative from the National Bank of Dominica, Ms. Nellister Daniel, the Senior Risk Officer.
Yes, good morning to everyone. My name is Ria Raymond from Abilities Unlimited, formerly known as Workshop for the Blind, where you get your double dips, or government supports us immensely. So if you're passing through ministry, you'll see our stuff on the desk or waste paper baskets. So we invite you to support us up at Goodwill Federation Drive anytime. Your Excellency Sylvain Burton and husband, Mr. Burton, board members of the President's Charity Foundation, recipients of the President's Charity Foundation, invited guests, the media. On behalf of the employees of the Workshop for the Blind, Abilities Unlimited, we wish to express our deepest thanks to Her Excellency Charity Foundation for selecting us to receive this generous donation. We at Abilities Unlimited are grateful for this donation that we contribute to our employees' take-home pay, because what happens during Christmas season, they work hard. So you see them out on the streets with their baskets, going out to sell. So that in turn builds up or bucks up their take-home pay. So we are grateful and we are immensely happy that they will go home this Christmas with a nice check, nice pay cut. So we are grateful. Once again, we wish to express our thanks and we thank you. Everybody, good morning. Merry Christmas and a happy and peaceful New Year. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Raymond. Just a reminder, whenever you see them with their baskets, please purchase, because we support something important, right? Now, she mentioned a little word. She said double dip. Remember that? Remember she said double dip? And, you know, because you're receiving this as your first Christmas gift, and on Christmas Day, you're going to get something else. What you're going to have is called a double dip. Excellent. So you're appreciative of the double dip. We follow? So let's go. We're living here with smiles in our, twinkles in our, filled with Christmas, showing, being capable of navigating, enjoying a bite of, appreciative of the double dip, and saying, yes, awesome. We continue with the Dominica Infirmary. Representative Miss Clanice John Baptist, the director, and the presenter, representative of Digicel, Mr. Victor Kovacs. He is the CEO.
Greetings, everyone, to the President, Her Excellency Sylvanie Burton and Mr. Burton, former excellencies, the recipients, the board, donors, everyone here, good morning.
Good morning.
I would first like to join in with the many others before me to congratulate Her Excellency Mrs. Sylvanie Burton in her new role as the President of the Commonwealth of Dominica. As a woman, I am indeed standing proud to see another woman sitting in the highest office of the land. It certainly proves that we women, how powerful and strong we can be. I know you will do a great job. With this said, on behalf of the Board of Directors, management, staff, and residents of the Dominica Infirmary, I wish to express sincere thanks to the President's Charity Foundation for this continuous financial support they provide to us over the years. As we know, this nonprofit institution provides a home for 93 elderly persons who are abandoned and less fortunate. They depend on us to care for them, to provide their basic needs and to display to them the love that most of them were not shown or given to at home. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank the government of Dominica for the monthly subvention. Without this funding, the institution would not be able to operate. I believe now that the onus is on the rest of us, in one way or the other, to support the institution. Those who continue to support, I say many, many, many thanks. And for those who have yet to come on board, I say, what are you waiting for? Oftentimes, persons would ask me what they can donate to the institution, apart from cash donations. I say, we welcome volunteerism. I am making a special appeal to everyone, and not just the businesses or the companies, private citizens, individuals like you and I. We are asking that you come on board, volunteer your skills. If you're a barber, if you're a carpenter, whatever skill that you are trading, we welcome you. This tool will make a meaningful impact on the elderly. Has anyone wondered what would happen to our elderly if the infirmary or institutions like this did not exist? I believe it's everyone's responsibility, together with the government. Since the elderly residing at the institution are of different political and religious beliefs, it will take all of us to keep it running effectively. I am indeed happy to be here today to receive this financial assistance given by the President's Charity Foundation, which will continue to allow us to provide this much needed service. Allow me to reiterate, the work and what this foundation stands for is of great importance to nation building. Touching the lives of the most vulnerable groups is what God asked us to do. I urge the donors to continue to donate, and I encourage everyone to attend the President's annual fundraising dinner. Double that amount next year. Finally, I wish everyone here a Merry Christmas and a bright and prosperous New Year. God bless you all.
Thank you very much, Ms. John Baptist. And she mentioned displaying love. And this is what the foundation is about. It's about displaying love to the vulnerable persons out there. So we're going to add this to our little repertoire. Okay? We're almost done. So we're living here with smiles on our twinkles in our filled with Christmas, showing, being capable of navigating, enjoying a bite of, appreciative of the double dip, you got that, and displaying, and of course, yes. We move on to the Alpha Center. I invite Representative Ms. Claudia Bellet. She's a deputy chairperson of the board. Presenter for this check, representative from Stowe and Co., that is legal and offshore services providers, Mr. Kyle Brown. He's the IT officer.
So I don't know if Monel is going to get any new words from me, but anyway, let's go. Her Excellency Sylvanie Burton, and I've been waiting to say that for a long time, and Mr. Burton, His Excellency Charles Savarin and Mrs. Savarin, His Excellency Eliud Williams, all our honorable ministers who are here present this morning, our invited guests, good morning to all. Morning. On behalf of the board, the staff, and students of the Alpha Center, I extend our deepest, sincerest appreciation for this donation from the President's Charities Foundation. The Alpha Center provides educational facilities for close to 40 to 50 students with learning disabilities. And next year, we will celebrate 50 years of existence as an organization. We will observe this milestone with a week of activities, which I trust all of you will participate in, and we will ensure that you are part of our celebration. It is really through the generous contributions of organizations like the President's Charities Foundation that the Alpha Center has been able to survive for 50 years and to grow its services to integrate children with disabilities into society, to live functional and happy lives. Once again, we thank you most sincerely for this gift, and we wish everyone a blessed Christmas and a very productive New Year. Thank you.
For those of you just joining DBS Radio, we are here live at the State House Conference Center for the annual President Charities Foundation, Inc. Cheque Donations Presentation Ceremony.
That Monel is not going to get any words from her. I did, you know. What did she mention about functioning? Is that about functioning and happy? Being happy? She mentioned that? So we can say that we're living here fully functional and happy, yeah? Because we got the steam that we needed. So we're gonna add this to our repertoire. So fully functional and happy, thanks to the President Charities Foundation. I got you. So we're living here with smiles in our, twinkles in our, filled with Christmas, showing being capable of navigating rough, enjoying bites of, appreciative of the, displaying love, and fully functional and happy. And not forgetting, saying yes. Awesome. And I'll return to Our Lady of Fairhaven. I believe there are two. So, representative from the St. Vincent de Paul branch. Okay, so this one goes towards the Roseau branch. So can I get a representative of Our Lady of Fairhaven? You're represented. And the presenter, apologies, give me 1 minute, but if you're here, please join us to the front. Batilia. So the representative is Marcel Harrigan, and the presenter, I apologize for the mix-up, I'm going to have this clarified. 1 minute, yes?
Thirteen charitable organizations will be benefiting from the Cheque donations being given today from the President Charities Foundation. A total of $36,000 will be going to these 13 beneficiaries. There are 16 beneficiaries of the President Charities Foundation, three of which received presentations earlier this week in a total of $8,000. They are the House of Hope, Grange, and Care for the Poor. We are going back to
the
Master of Ceremonies, Manuel Alexis, for continuing with the program.
Give me a word. Come here, what? What's that? Hippie Puri. Okay, this is excellent. Hip, hip, hooray. Hooray. Excellent. So we go from the top. We're living here with smiles in our, twinkles in our, filled with Christmas, showing, being, capable of navigating, enjoying a bite of, appreciative of the, displaying, filled with, fully, and happy, saying, yes and, hip hip hip, hooray! Excellent, well done. So at this juncture, permit me to recognize the sponsors one more time who made this event possible. I recognize the sponsors of the President's Charities Dinner, the Embassy of the People's Republic of China, H.H. Bewitt Church and Company Limited, Aid Bank, National Bank of Dominica, National Cooperative Credit Union, West Coast Cooperative Credit Union, Dominica Social Security, Dominica Electricity Services Limited, Domlec, DoIt Center, Springfield Trading Limited, Belfast Estates Limited, Rudolph F. Thomas Enterprises, M&R Trading Limited, Rock Hard Cement, Construction Materials and Services Limited, Specialty Making and Materials Limited, Stowe and Company, Intercontinental Dominica Cabrits Resort and Spa, Jungle Bay Dominica Resort and Spa, Archipelago Trading Limited, Sacred Bay Resort, L'Express des Îles, Val Ferry Services, Flow Dominica, the Giselle Dominica, and Print Express. Please put your hands together for all the sponsors and for the donors who participated in the President's Charities Dinner. Up next, we say thank you. For that, I invite to the podium the treasurer of the President's Charities Foundation, Mrs. Romalda Hyacinth.
Good afternoon. Her Excellency Sylvanie Burton, President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, and Mr. Burton. His Excellency Charles A. Savre, former President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, and Mrs. Savre. His Excellency Eliot T. Williams, former President of the Commonwealth of Dominica. Honorable Miriam Blanchard, Minister for Labor, Public Service Reform, Social Partnership, Entrepreneurship, and Small Business Development, and Parliamentary Representative for the Roseau North constituency. Honorable Kasani Laville, Minister for Health, Wellness, and Social Services, and Parliamentary Representative for the Mahou constituency. Honorable Dr. Cassandra Williams, Minister of State, in the Ministry of Health and Social Services, with specific responsibility for seniors, security, children at risk, gender affairs, and the differently abled. Monsignor Eustace Thomas, officials of the Embassy of the People's Republic of China, sponsors, representatives of the various charitable organizations, present and past members of the President Charities Foundation, the media, and the listening and viewing public. I am pleased to deliver the vote of thanks at this special event on behalf of the President Charities Foundation. We are happy that you were able to attend and be part of this presentation. Thank you to Your Excellency and First Gentleman, Mr. Burton, for spearheading the foundation and for being here to assist in making the lives of some of our vulnerable citizens better through this Cheque presentation. I am particularly delighted to be able to express our heartfelt thanks to our sponsors and to all those who supported and participated in the President's Charities Foundation fundraising dinner, which was held on Saturday, 14th October, 2023, at the Jungle Bay Resort and Spa. Your act of kindness made today's presentation ceremony possible. It gives me great pleasure again to thank all our sponsors, the Embassy of the People's Republic of China, HHV Whitchurch and Company Limited, Aid Bank, National Bank of Dominica, National Cooperative Credit Union, West Coast Cooperative Credit Union, Dominica Social Security, Dominica Electricity Services Limited, DoIt Center, Springfield Trading Limited and Belfast Estate Limited, Rudolph F. Thomas Enterprises, M&R Trading Limited, Rockhard Cement, Construction Materials and Services Limited, Dragon Windows, Specialty Making and Materials Limited, Zoo Windows, Stowe and Co., Legal and Offshore Services Providers, Intercontinental Dominica Cabaret Resort and Spa, Jungle Bay Dominica Resort and Spa, Archipelago Trading Limited, Secret Bay Resort, La Express des Iles, Val Ferry Services, Flow Dominica, Digicel Dominica, and Print Express. We say a big thank you. To you who are sitting here, thank you for taking time off your busy schedule and for showing support to the humanitarian efforts of the foundation. Former President Savre and Mrs. Savre, and former President Eliud Williams for attending. Honorable Miriam Blanchard and Dr. Cassandra Williams for attending and delivering brief remarks. Honorable Cassini Laville, Monsignor Eustace Thomas for offering the invocation and for always readily accepting whenever called upon by the Office of the President to provide spiritual support. To Mr. Oliver St. John for delivering the welcome remarks. Representatives of the various charitable organizations for attending and accepting the donations and for your expression of good wishes. The media houses for covering the proceedings of the presentation ceremony for the listening and viewing public. The staff of the Office of the President for the coordinating the necessary administrative and logistic arrangements for the hosting of the presentation ceremony. To everyone who assisted in presenting the checks, to the representatives of the various charitable organizations, to the listening and viewing public for making time to follow this check donation presentation ceremony. And last, but by no means least, Ms. Monel Alexis for presiding over the proceedings of the check donation presentation ceremony with such confidence, as usual, zeal, and clarity. We are thankful to all of you for your support and your unwavering commitment to the President's Charities Foundation and to the well-being of the vulnerable persons being cared for by the 16 charitable organizations. Again, thank you, and may God bless you 100-fold. A very Merry Christmas and a bright and prosperous 2024. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Hyacinth. I've noted you chuckled when you mentioned my name. We will discuss this later. Now remember, the best way to not feel hopeless is to get up and do something. Don't wait for good things to happen to you. If you go out and make some good things happen, he will fill the world with hope, and he will fill yourself with hope as well. I say a big congratulations to all the recipients of the check today. I encourage all the sponsors who have sponsored the previous dinner to please join us in 2024. And if you are out there, you have a business, or if you want to contribute in any way, shape, or form, please feel free to do so. But before we leave, it would be remiss of me to not go over what we would have discussed throughout this day. Because we are living here with smiles on our faces, twinkles in our
eyes,
filled with Christmas, showing, being capable of navigating, enjoying a bite of, appreciative of the dub, displaying, being fully functional and saying no. Which one first? Saying hip hip hip, and of course saying yes. Ladies and gentlemen, it had been my pleasure serving as your master of ceremonies for this event. I wish you a wonderful day and a merry and blessed Christmas. My name is Mornell Alexis. Do have a wonderful day. Thank you.
And this brings us to the end of the President Charities Foundation, Inc. Cheque donation presentation ceremony here at the State House.
You're not going to go over it again.
13 beneficiaries received the cheques today from the President Charities Foundation, including the Dominican Association of Persons with Disabilities, St. Jerome's Ministry, Dominica Council on Aging, REACH, Our Lady of Fairhaven Conference of St. Vincent de Paul Society to the Rosa Branch, the National Society of St. Vincent de Paul Limited towards the Northern Branch, the Social Center towards the St. Anne's Nursery, Operation Youthquake, the Maho Senior Citizens Home, Community Hostels Inc., formerly known as the Grotto Home for the Homeless, Ability and Abilities Unlimited, formerly known as the Workshop for the Blind, the Dominican Infirmary, and the Alpha Center. A total of $36,000 was handed over in these checks this morning, and a previous $8,000 presented to the House of Hope, Grange, and Care for the Poor, bringing to a total 16 beneficiaries of this year's President Charities Foundation, and a grand total of $44,000 in total donations this year, this Christmas. So on behalf of the entire outside broadcast team here at DB at the State House, Dean Thomas and Aaron Wilshire, I'm Kashina Joseph, taking you back to the Ted Daily Studio at DBS Radio.